Good morning, my dear students. So today in part 4 matrices, I am going to discuss some definitions which are not in NCERT textbook. Okay. So first definition, idempotent matrix. So a square matrix capital A is said to be idempotent matrix. A square matrix capital A is said to be idempotent matrix if A square is equal to A. If A square is equal to A, then only it is an idempotent matrix. A square matrix capital A is said to be idempotent matrix if A square is equal to A. So example for idempotent matrix is equal to capital A is equal to 2 minus 2 minus 4 minus 1 3 4 1 minus 2 minus 3. So it is an example for idempotent matrix. Just a copy. I hope you copied. First row 2 minus 2 minus 4. Second row minus 1, 3, 4. Third row 1 minus 2 minus 3. So for idempotent matrix, see here. Suppose if I want to calculate A cube, for idempotent matrix, what I have to calculate? Suppose A square is equal to A only in a definition. If I want to calculate A cube matrix, so what is A cube matrix? A cube is equal to, can I write like this, A square into A? But from the definition, A square is what? A. From the definition, A square is what? A. This A as it is, A into A, A square. Again, from the definition, A square is equal to what? A. So thus, A cube also what you got? A. If you find A power 4 also, A. If A is idempotent, a definition prakara, A square is equal to A. But what you got? A cube also what you are getting? A. If you find A power 4, A power 5, A power 6, in general, A power n is also A. For all n is natural number. Okay. And one more definition for this is also there. Okay. Suppose A and B are two matrices. A and B are two square matrices. A and B are two square matrices. Satisfying the condition that AB is equal to B and BA is equal to A. Then compulsorily A and B must be idempotent. A and B must be what? Idempotent. Or AB is equal to A, B and BA is equal to B. In this case also A and B must be what? Idempotent. So idempotent means what? Definition prakar A square is equal to A. Okay. By using these conditions we can prove that A square is equal to A, B square is equal to B. Hence we can conclude that A and B are idempotent matrices. Okay. One example on this. Idempotent matrix. One example on idempotent matrix. If A is an idempotent, then what is A plus A square plus A cube plus and so on A power n matrix? N is a natural number. Okay. As A is idempotent, just now discussed where A square is A and we proved A cube also A, we can prove that A power n also A. So here how many terms are there? A power 1, A power 2, A power 3 and so on A power n. Number of terms is n. And as A is idempotent, this is A, this matrix also A, this term also A. So all terms are equal to A. How many terms are there? N terms. So A plus A plus A plus A, how many times? N times. So it is equal to what? N times of A. N times of A. So that was the answer. And I want to explain some interesting point here. What is the determinant of idempotent matrix? What are the possible values for determinant of idempotent matrix? So from the definition, what we have? A square is equal to A. So both sides apply A. What you'll get? Det of A square is equal to det of A. Det of A square is same as det A whole square. that plus dTa, if we transfer this here, this side, minus dTa is equal to 0. On solving this equation, you will get dTa value either 0 or 1. That means the determinant of an idempotent matrix will be either 0 or 1. Okay? Next to definition, orthogonal matrix. So, a square matrix is said to be orthogonal matrix if A into A dash is nothing but A transpose. Okay? A into A dash is equal to A dash into A is equal to I. So, it is look like A into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A is equal to I only, no? Yes. So, for orthogonal matrix, inverse of the matrix is same as A dash. Actually, it is the definition. Okay? A square matrix satisfying this condition is orthogonal matrix. But it is look like A into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A is equal to I. That means A dash, instead of A dash, what do we have? Sorry, instead of A inverse, what do we have? A dash. So, that means for orthogonal matrix, A dash is same as A inverse. A dash is same as A inverse. Okay? And example for this orthogonal matrix is 2 by 2 matrix cos theta minus sin theta cos, sorry, sin theta cos theta. So, it is an example for orthogonal matrix. So, first row cos theta minus sin theta, second row sin theta cos theta. And here also some interesting point. What are the possible values of determinant of orthogonal matrix? So, by definition, what do we have? A dash is equal to I. Then determinant of A dash is equal to what? Determinant of I. So, determinant of A dash can be written as what? Det A into det of A dash is equal to determinant of I is what? 1. And we know that determinant of A dash is same as determinant of A. So, det A into det A dash. Det A dash is same as det A. Det A into det A, det A whole square. Det A whole square is equal to 1 means det A will be what? Either 1 or minus 1. So, the possible values of determinant of an orthogonal matrix is either 1 or minus 1. That means orthogonal matrix is always invertible and its inverse is same as its transpose. A dash. Next, invalidary matrix. So, a square matrix is said to be invalidary matrix if A square is equal to identity matrix. A square is equal to identity matrix. Then here if you apply both sides det, det of A square is equal to det of I. Det of A square is same as det A whole square. Det of I is equal to 1. Det A whole square is equal to 1 means det A is equal to what? Plus or minus 1. That means the determinant of an invalidary matrix is also what? Either 1 or minus 1. An example for invalidary matrix is capital A is equal to 3 by 3 matrix. First row is minus 5, minus 8, 0. Second row, 3, 5, 0. Third row, 1, 2, minus 1. So if you calculate A square, you will get identity matrix. It is an example for invalidary matrix. Then if you find determinant of A, you will get answer is either 1 or minus 1. Next, nilpotent matrix. So, a square matrix, capital A is said to be nilpotent matrix. A square matrix, capital A is said to be nilpotent matrix. If A power m is equal to null matrix for some natural number m, okay, then we say that A is a null matrix. If this power m is the least power or least positive integer satisfying A power m is equal to 0, then this m is called index. M is called index of the matrix A. If m is the least positive integer satisfying A power m is equal to 0, then m is called index of A. So, nilpotent matrix definition is what? A square matrix satisfying which condition? A power m is equal to null matrix for some natural number m. Okay? If m is the least positive integer satisfying A power m is equal to 0, then m is called index. Example for nilpotent matrix, 3 by 3 matrix again. First row 1, 1, 3. Second row 5, 2, 6. Third row minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. And if you calculate, you will get A cube is equal to null matrix. So what is the index of this nilpotent matrix?
0.
And as A power m is equal to delta of A whole power m, delta of A power m is equal to delta of 0 matrix. That means the delta A whole power m is equal to determinant of 0 matrix is 0. So delta A is equal to what? 0. That means the nilpotent matrix is always singular. That means it is not invertible matrix. A inverse does not exist for nilpotent matrix. Next, definition. Periodic matrix. I think Hopper. Next definition. Periodic matrix. A square matrix satisfying the condition A power k plus 1 is equal to A for some natural number k. Then A is called periodic matrix. A is called periodic matrix. A square matrix satisfying this condition is called periodic matrix. Here k is some natural number. If k is the least positive integer, k is the least positive integer. K is the least positive integer such that A power k plus 1 is equal to A, then this k is called period of A. For example, here idempotent definition we discussed. A square is equal to what you got? A. So A square is equal to A means here what you will get? A power 1 plus 1 is equal to A only. So here instead of k, what we have? 1. That means k value is what? 1. That means an idempotent matrix is also periodic matrix of period how much? 1. And remember, the period of square null matrix is not defined. The period of square null matrix is not defined. So next to definitions. Definition, unitary matrix. So the definition is A into A power theta is equal to A power theta into A is equal to I. So a square matrix satisfying this condition is called unitary matrix. Next, Hermitian matrix. Hermitian is a name. Hermitian matrix. A square matrix capital A is said to be Hermitian matrix if A power theta is equal to A. A power theta is equal to A. Example for Hermitian matrix is 2 plus 3i, 2 minus 3i and 4. Just you take this non-diagonal elements, only one element. Suppose if you take A12 is A plus IB form, A21 is its conjugate, 2 minus 3. Then automatically it will become Hermitian matrix. So if you find its A power theta, that means A power theta is what? Conjugate of transpose of the matrix. Or transpose of conjugate of the matrix. Okay. So obviously what will be the definition for skew Hermitian? Yes, it is correct. Skew Hermitian definition will be what? Hermitian is A power theta is equal to A. Skew Hermitian is what? A square matrix capital A is said to be skew Hermitian if A power theta is equal to minus A. If A power theta is equal to minus A. Remember, in skew Hermitian also diagonal elements are equal to 0. So it is an example for skew Hermitian. It is an example for Hermitian. Okay. So these are the some definitions. So these are the some definitions which are not present in NCERT textbook. Okay? Which are not present in the NCERT textbook. Thank you. So with this, the theory part of the matrix is over. Next session I am going to start some problems. Thank you.